Hi guys, here I am again, Stineke from Steam Art. My friend Ria had a wonderful idea. Because of the coronavirus in all over the world, there are countries that have a lockdown. People can't buy anything as quick. And when you pour a lot, you can run out of canvases. So she had an idea. When you want to practice or you want to make some skins, then cover a canvas you already used or a new one, just what you want. I already did this one. I wanted to do a blob painting on it, but I did not come to it. So we wrap it in this foil where you can make presents from, and then you can pour on it. I'm going to try right now, and I loved it when you are watching with me how it goes. I see you in a minute. Well, here I am again. I'm back. Now I'm gonna try. My friend does it all the time and it works perfect with her. So I thought, well, we're gonna try it too. I prepared some paints. They are all, like always, from Amsterdam. Sometimes I use the Artina paints too. I really love them. I don't care how my corners are going to work out, because I want to make some jewelry of the skins that I come out of this. I want to grab myself a brush to prepare my base. I think if you run out of canvases, or you just don't want to ruin them with something you want to practice, then it's a wonderful idea. When it's dry, you can peel off the painting of the foil, and then you can use the skins to glue them on something, and, well, like I want to do, make jewelry of it. I'm feeling a little strange. It works a little different for my feeling. But we're gonna see. I'm going to do an flip cup. Wanna throw it on the canvas and see what happens. I wanna torch my air bubbles. I hope my torch has some gas left. There are some big air bubbles. Torch a little bit too long, I believe. Well, I made up some turquoise, purple, red, bronze, black, white, and I used neon from the deco art. I hope you can see it, and we'll see what's coming out of it. I prepared about a half cup. I cut off the upper half because I always get too much paint. I thought this reminds me not to use too much paint. Well, here we go. I want to wait a few moments. My paint will drop down. My paint has to settle a little bit. There's nothing coming out anymore. I'm gonna torch my air bubbles. Of course, I forgot to tell you, I used in every color 3 drops of silicone oil. I hope you can see. It's this one I used. Well, let's go on tilting a little bit. It feels a little bit strange because of the paper. Mostly I put my fingers on the sides, but that doesn't work now. So let's see what's going to happen now. I want to create some effects for jewelry. And I believe that it works not to take too large cups because I don't have much paint what's falling off now. I really like this. Now I want to touch a little bit. I think I used this one, a little heat blower. I just made up my paint so you can see there are a lot of air bubbles bursting. But because I thought I'm going to use it for jewelry, it's not a big deal. I really love these parts with the neon. It goes very quickly. Now we have to wait and see how it dries. I love these parts too. I can see a lot of beautiful parts where I can glue up my stones. I want to make the cobochons. Maybe you have seen me posting some in the Facebook group. I'm wearing one of my own bracelets. And I always, it's already covered in paint, so it suits me best. Well, I think this one is ready. I have to put it in the dry rack. Then we go to number two. So I put you on hold. Well, I take it away. I post a picture after the video so you can see what it become when it's dry. Well, I'm showing this one up close. The colors are very beautiful. There's a lot of red. I didn't use much, but there's a lot of in it. Well, let's go on to the next one. Hi guys, I'm back for the next one. This one I want to do a little bit different. Place my cup first, then put some little paint around. And see what we create, what happened. I want to take use of my brush. It still feels a little strange with my brush because it's so slippery from the bottom. The foily is so smooth. But like I said, if you want to practice something, you did not. What you don't do very good yet. There's something in my paint. For my base layer, I use wall paint. How do I say it? One-on-one with my PM. That's Artist Junior. 60% and 40% water. And I use by Amsterdam acrylics. One-on-one. With the Artist Junior, again 60% artis junior glue and 40% of water. And then I mix those two together. And then I add a little bit of water to the right consistency that I want. It's a little bit cheaper because I just use it for the underground, underlayer. Normal, all to use all Amsterdam. It's a little bit much for my wallet. And the wall paint, well, it goes always quite nice. I used black and white, silver, and the deco art Americana neon in this one. So I'm very curious what the effect will be. This time I want to run a strict stick through because the silver is all at the top. I don't like that, but it does not go away, and I use just a little bit. It's very dominant. Well, we're gonna see what we're going to get. I want to tilt a little. If I don't like it, well, it's not a shame. This is for practice too. It's also a way to practice your colors. If you want to make a canvas of some colors, it's maybe a cheap way like this to practice first. I'm sorry, I'm getting out of camera. Well, I just leave it like this, that the edges. And again, I did not spoil a lot of paint with those half cups like I used to. When I spoil a lot of paint, what's falling down I use for the jewelry. I put my stones in it, I dip them. Maybe I can show you that, how I do that sometime too. My gas is running out. These are very nice spots to make some jewelry off. So this is a new technique I'm trying to learn, like my friend does too. But she's very good in it. I'm a little bit jealous. I want to master myself this too. I don't blame myself for over-torching. I know you can get beautiful effects when you do. And because this is now canvas for keep, I can do everything I want. Even put in a balloon, because I don't like that spot silver. Well, I cleaned up my little craft room and now I'm lost of my stuff where I put it, because I put some things on different places, and then when you need it you have to think, oh my god, where did I left it? This creates effects that I can use too when it dries. When it is dry, I'm sorry for my English. I try to do better, but you see, in the silver I get more neon now. And I like to make some jewelry with a lot of neon in it. I know some people love that. Well, this was it. my practicing. I'm gonna take you down, show it, and when it's dry, I put the dry pictures. When I don't forget it, then I put the dry pictures behind the video. Well, here it is. This is it. I can come some closer. I can show you the really nice parts. The parts I like, those parts. And this. There are some beautiful spots to glue my stones on. Maybe I show you my jewelry when it's finished too. Well, I'm gonna say thank you for watching and I hopefully see you the next time. Bye bye! Hi guys, here I am, Stineke again. Well, this is my pour on the plastic. You can see it's dry now. So I'm going to get it off. And I let you see it later when I peel it off the plastic. Hi guys, I'm back. This one is off the canvas now. I made a little start and then you can do your hands below and you can, you see, take it off. You can save it between two layers of cookie paper. And yeah, you can use it anytime you want. This is the bag. It's very easy. This one too. You see how it goes off? Maybe you could reuse the plastic. If you want, you can let it dry more so it's all okay to use. This one, I want to show you this one that you have to make a little start. I did not prepare this one so you can see how I do it. Put your fingers below. Where there is a little bit of trouble. And here we are, off it is. So this way you can practice or make skin, whatever you want. I'm happy to share it with you. Thank you. Hi guys, I wanted to share this with you too. I glued with this glue. Yeah, you can't see the brand, but I bought it on AliExpress. And I glued some stones on my skin. They have to dry now. I want to show it a little bit. I picked out some spaces that I liked. And now it has to dry. Then I can cut it out and put it in the bezel. They call it bezel. These types of things. Well, thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.